Korean Zombie is one of the most exciting fighters in the sport of MMA. He had already established that before he even arrived to the UFC in 2011, but for the past 9 years, he has only furthered the belief that he's one of the most entertaining fighters the sport has ever seen. Out of his 8 fights in the UFC, he's walked away with performance bonuses 7 times, in all the different variety. Knockout of the night, submission of the night, fight of the night. It's one thing to be a fighter that's racked up a lot of bonuses over the course of his career, but to do it in almost every single performance on the biggest stage in the world is special, and Korean Zombie is definitely special. He is even spectacular in his losses, most notable in the last L he took against Yair Rodriguez, which will go down as one of the most thrilling KOs in UFC history. KZ was looking sharp as ever in the 5th round up until the very last second when Rodriguez threw that Hail Mary buzzer-beating elbow that knocked Zombie dead. Even knowing the outcome, it's still shocking when you go back and watch that fight. Although he was on the wrong end of that one, he was still a key component to providing the type of action that the fans are here to see. A lot of fighters that end up on the receiving end of such a devastating knockout never fully recover. The Rodriguez Zombie knockout was the kind of KO that can change a fighter forever, both mentally and physically. So it's always very interesting to see how a fighter will respond to that. Despite taking a loss, Zombie is such a high-valued commodity in that company. His next fight was another 5-round main event against Hanato Moicano, a fight which he looked as sharp and composed from the opening bell as he always does, as he proceeded to walk forward and uncork a super-fast overhand right that landed flush, sending Moicano down to the mat as he ate another left hand along the way, signaling the beginning of the end, and walking away with a TKO victory in less than 1 minute. Another first-round TKO victory over former champion Frankie Edgar in a main event slot, and Chan Sung Jung now finds himself in another main event against Brian Ortega, but this time, there are definitely title implications. Ortega is as dangerous of a grappler as it can possibly get. Not just any featherweight, but virtually any fighter across all weight classes that gets their neck snatched up by T-City is in serious trouble. The grappling pedigree makes him a very dangerous match for anybody, Korean Zombie included. And as great as Zombie's jiu-jitsu is, should the fight hit the mat? Personally, all I can imagine is Ortega controlling the fight. He is dangerous in all areas, but I find those guys who like working off their backs are generally the most dangerous, and he's a constant threat that's going to give KZ a lot of trouble should it go to the ground. Not to mention he's tough as hell. His chin is proven as well as his heart. The UFC matchmakers did an awesome job with this one. Stylistically, this one has all the makings for an entertaining affair. And not to give this too much credit, but there's also an added element of intrigue to the out-of-the-cage drama, which is very real. All too often we see beef between fighters because of some nonsense they're getting on with Twitter. And personally, especially these days, that does absolutely nothing for me in terms of my interest in the fight. But the drama between these two did get physical when Ortega allegedly confronted the friend slash translator of Zombie at a UFC event and slapped him while Zombie was in the bathroom, which apparently upset KZ greatly. They don't seem to be bringing that beef in a fight week, and that's perfectly fine by me, but I suppose it's worth noting. But all that aside, I absolutely love this fight, and it's worth making sure you catch it this weekend. I think very highly of Brian Ortega as a fighter. I love specialists, and for me, it makes things really interesting when it's very clear what one fighter's advantage is and to see if they can impose it. Ortega also has power in his hands, as he showed in the Frankie Edgar fight, when he hit Edgar with that uppercut that lifted him off his feet. But with all due respect to Ortega, I don't think this fight against Zombie is a good matchup for him. While he did score that incredible KO over Edgar, I always believe that Frankie looked past Ortega in that fight. If you remember, Edgar was supposed to take on Holloway that night for the title, but when Holloway pulled out, Ortega stepped up on 3 weeks' notice. It's not that Frankie didn't see Ortega as a threat, but I always did get the feeling that he was just a little complacent in that fight, and had he been on high alert with the focus he normally brings in the cage, I think that fight would have turned out differently. While Ortega does have power in his hands, he's not the fastest guy in the world, and perhaps even a little predictable, striking-wise, to a guy like Zombie, who has incredibly fast hands, coupled with good power and really good accuracy. No matter how this thing goes down, we are in for a barn burner come Saturday night. Zombie is a slight favorite heading into this fight, and for good reason. It's tailor-made for him to get another impressive victory and solidify himself as the number one contender of the featherweight division. I do realize that Zabit is out there, but if Zombie can win as impressively as I think he will, I think the next title shot should be all his. Chan Sung Jung is a performer. When the lights are at their brightest and the stage is at its biggest, he executes amazing performances. So expect nothing less this Saturday. Korean Zombie delivers every time.